I think the biggest problem right now is that the financial system globally is still incredibly fragile, and unfortunately, it's still backed up by what used to be called the implicit guarantees of the government that are now explicit guarantees, or they became explicit in 2008, and people are now pretending again that they're implicit. Well, they're not implicit. And so we still have an economy or a financial system that's largely driven by too-big-to-fail banks that get subsidies they're not entitled to and ultimately get access to the taxpayer's pocket. The problem with that is we end up with an oversupply of credit that's not going to the productive economy. And because it's not going to the productive economy, lending to real people, real businesses, small, medium, and large, we've got low economic growth, lower productivity, and lower wages. And so the result is we're kind of caught in this cycle where finance continues to do well over and over again because speculation and financialization is incredibly lucrative to a couple of thousand bankers. What we don't have is a financial system that really is focused on and supporting the real economy that would benefit the people of the world. Which, interestingly, if you benefited the people of the world, if you actually had greater productivity, greater growth, greater prosperity, everybody would benefit, including the financial sector. And the economic profession has to start rethinking fundamentally the way they think about economics, macroeconomics in particular, so that we reverse the hierarchy, so that the focus is not on the financial system at the top and everybody else at the bottom, that the productive economy is at the top, and finance goes back to its support role for the real economy. That's the fundamental challenge of our time.